Hey everybody, you guys are going to do a research project that will be done individually for respiratory diseases. This will count as your test grade for respiratory system. So what you're going to do is you're going to choose one of the, you're going to read through the lesson description, and then you're going to choose one of the respiratory diseases listed. You need to, when you choose your respiratory disease, you need to post it because no two students in the classroom can do the same disease. You're going to create a newsletter. If you don't know what a newsletter is, Google that. Find some examples of newsletters. It would be like a one-page newspaper. It could be set up in little blocks where you just discuss the different things that it's telling you to do. And then what you're going to do is you're going to use images and make it really something that you want to look at. You're going to create a header, a headline, you know, all those kind of things that you would do for a newsletter. You're going to create a newsletter teaching about the disease that you, or the respiratory issue that you have chosen. Then it needs to be front and back, or it needs to be front only, but you need to make sure those are printed out because on Monday, or for some of you it may be Tuesday, because of how things are going at school. I know some of you are going to be gone, so it may be Tuesday before we finish this up. But you're going to create that newsletter, and one of the things you have to do is you, at the very end of your newsletter, you have to have three questions about your disease. Those three questions, then, as every you're going to go around the room, you're going to kind of set those newsletters out, or you're going to exchange them, and you're going to read everyone else's newsletter. And once you finish reading their newsletter, you're going to answer the questions. But the creation of your newsletter, along with those questions, are going to be going to be your test grade for respiratory. So please make it as creative as possible. Look at the grading rubric. Once you read through the lesson and watch this video, then read the rubric so you know what you're supposed to be making sure is in there so you get a good grade on it. Put some effort into it. Make it creative. And work on it, because you'll learn a whole lot about not just only the disease process you choose, but the ones your fellow students do. I'm actually going to ask that your in-class facilitator also allow you time to read. If there's more than one class of principals at your school, I'm also going to ask that she share other students' respiratory issue or respiratory newsletters with you as well. So you guys have a great day, and I will be back with you next week. Thank you.